So I guess the tactic today is just go super light. 1 pound test is what I'm going to be using with this jig. And that way the trout won't be able to see my lure, my line. And yeah, that's the plan. There's one, first cast. It's a decent sized fish too. It's all about that 1 pound test. Just take your time and play him out. That is a decent fish. I'm just using this braid to kind of keep power on a fish. Come on. There we go. Alright, so I'm just putting on the spinner just to see if I can't get a reaction strike, kind of. It's not really a reaction strike, but just seeing if I can't get a big bad fish to come on out. Just get really pissed off of this thing. I want the big mamba jam to come on out. There he is. That's a good fish. Yes. Okie dokie. That is a keeper for sure. Wait a minute. Did I leave my net down there? Shit. I left my net down here. Crap, this isn't good at all. Oh. That's a good fish. That is a keeper for sure. Oh man, he's pulling hard. Come on. Come on. Come on, fish. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Oh, come on. Yes. Okay. Oh, one little weed dragon out there. Oh, that's a big trout. Please be in the mood for biting. Oh, yes, 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 yes. No! That's torture. Come on, man. Oh, you're kidding me, dude. What don't you like about it? Tell me, man, what don't you like about it? Man. Here he is. Should I keep this fish or not? Yeah, I'll go ahead and keep this fish. Huh. Okay then. Maybe I won't even get a chance to keep this fish. I think he might have me buried in some grass pretty bad. Yeah. May not even get a chance. Here he comes. I know. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, I should probably keep him. I know, if he's at least a pound, I'll keep him. Putting up a good fight, though. Alright, now I got him, I think. I think he ran out of gas. There we go, fish. Yeah. Maybe he didn't run out of gas. Okay, now I got you. Decent sized male. Yeah, I'll keep him. It's a good fish. And I tired him out. He'll probably just die. I tired him out pretty bad. I'll just make sure my last fish is at least 2 pounds. Make sure my stringer stays about 4 fish for 6, 7, 8 pounds. All right. Good deal, good deal. Good deal. Oh, yeah, definitely a male. God damn it. Oh, man, that's nasty. Jeez. Ugh, disgusting. Fish just splooged on me. Come on. That's disgusting. Look at that. It's just nasty. Well, I'm going to turn the camera off just so I can start cleaning up. This is disgusting. But when you come back, we should be moving down to the next spot. Dang fish. See a lot of fish like that guy. This park is chock full of fish like that. See, they're pretty easy to catch. Oh, well, spit it out super high speeds. But you see all kinds of fish that are, ooh, that's a big fish. That's a 2-pounder. Come on. And a lot of these fish have been caught, tossed back by fly fishermen. Come on, man. Dang it. That's a toad. There's another big fish out here. Hope he's mine. Ooh. Oh. Dang it. Oh, it hurts when I look at you and then turn away. Oh. Considering that was a nice fish, too. Oh, come on. Oh, come on, fish. Ah, dang it. I don't think that one's gonna play. Come on. Some stock up in here, I think. Hopefully they're keeper sized. Oh, there he is. Oh, he spit it out. Dang it. Better bring my net down here. That's some good fish. All stacked up in that little hole. All I gotta do is get one and I can go back, clean these fish up, have some lunch. I guess opposite order, have some lunch and clean these fish up. Oh, there he is. I don't know if there's a bigger fish than that in here. That might be, yeah, that's pretty much all I need. Yeah, that's a good fish. Yeah. Let's see, is there a better fish in here? I don't think so. I don't know, maybe there is. Let me take a look. It's gonna wear him out. 1-pound test style. There's a pretty good fish over there. That's a pretty nice fish. This fish turns to be out about 2 pounds. I should probably just call it. There's another good fish. I don't know. We'll just play it by how this fish looks. Also, I don't want to wear her out to the point where I'll just kill her. Yeah, it's a pretty good fish. I'll call it number 4. Yeah, I'll call it number 4, I think. My hands are cold anyway. Stocky fish too. She'll have a lot of meat. Oh, come on. Come on. Oh, man. Oh, all covered in gunk, but it'll do. Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Ready?
Yeah.
All right, now we're on to the cooking with Chef Jim Bob over there. You'll see him tomorrow throwing crankbaits probably. Crankbaits. So all you're gonna do here is we have these all nice and cleaned up and filleted. You wanna try to bleed out as much water and blood as possible. So that's why they're pink. You don't want them dark red. You want them as light as color as you can possibly get. All you're gonna do is take them somewhat wet, just cause they're always gonna be a little moist. Toss it in the seasoning. I use Andy's fish breading. Toss it in there, toss it on the backside. Do it once more. Make sure you get a good coating in there. And then put on a plate for later. You really can't overcoat them with this breading and seasoning. You really can't. This guy's actually kind of big, so I'm gonna cut him in half. You don't want it to take too long in the frying pan because you're just gonna burn the edges and you're just gonna lose half your meat pretty much. So make sure you get them coated really well, just really thick. Sometimes when they're on the plate, I'll even sprinkle some more on there just to make sure you get them thickly coated with seasoning. You really can't coat it too thick, I promise you. Once you have enough that you're ready for the fryer, hand it over to the chef. And all the chef's gonna do is just plop it on in there. Watch out for the grease splatter. Just kind of lay it in there. You know what I'm saying?
I think so.
Just gently lay it. Don't freak out about it. There you go. All right, so you're gonna see it's gonna be bubbling like this.
Can we do multiple?
Yeah, you can put another one in there. You just wanna be careful. You don't want to get the oil to cool down. When the oil cools down, it's taking too long to cook it. It'll just kind of make a flap. You don't put that one in. So especially if you're dealing with frozen fish, wait like a minute in between batches. Does that make sense? Because you're gonna cool your oil down. So basically, once you start seeing them float kind of a little bit of golden brown, you're just gonna turn them over and you're done. And it should only take for this kind of size stuff, it should only take maybe a minute 20, maybe. It shouldn't take very long. We have the oil as hot as we can possibly get, which is 420 degrees Fahrenheit, chabra. And it's super hot. It's super hot. That's at least what the stove is set to. So you can already see it kind of browning, a little bit christening over, and you'll start to see them float a little bit better. Maybe give them a nudge. You don't want them to stick to the bottom of the pan just to be sure, because if they stick there, they're going to get uneven heating. So I'll take that back. Get some more going.
I'll grab another plate.
This is the plate for when you put them on.
Yeah.
Like I said, you really can't overload too much on the breading. I'm not too much of a fish guy, so I don't know. I just don't like unseasoned fish. Like I said, when you get something like this big, go ahead and cut it in half just so it cooks a lot better. And really work the seasoning in. Because pretty much as soon as it hits the water, it's gonna lose, or hits the oil, it'll lose half of its seasoning on there. So you really can't.
That's about good.
Yeah, they probably, did you flip them?
No.
You don't really flip them, you just kind of have to make sure that they're being evenly cooked.
I was gonna say, flipping's not gonna do much.
So let's see how they're gonna come out. Let's see.
They're getting pretty sturdy.
Here. Sometimes you can just kind of bleed some of the air out of them. They're really close.
Yeah.
This one's almost done. That's
good. That should be done too.
Oh yeah, that's done. You're right.
Are you getting splattered with oil?
No.
All
Just be gentle with it.
Am I taking this one out?
Yeah. You gotta, the main thing with this is that you got to let them, see how we have that paper towel down there? You have to let the oil drain out of that fish as best you can. Because if you leave that oil in there and it gets kind of cold, it's gonna taste like crap. It really will. So this way you're just kind of bleeding the oil out and you're making it taste a lot better.
Give it a second, it feels cool.
And basically we're just gonna keep doing this until we get all of them done. If you really wanted to get fancy, you would use something like peanut oil or something like that. Those are the really good oils, but we're cheap and you can just get this oil that we use. It's just basic vegetable oil. And I don't know, it probably costs like $2 for a gallon of it. So it's real cheap. This Andy's fish breading, I love it. You can get in two flavors, yellow and kind of like a red orange flavor. It's literally the flavor they say. Yellow. And it tastes really, really good and they're super cheap. So, you know, if you're just trying to catch some fish and have kind of like a budget fry, some vegetable oil, a fryer, some breading, some Andy's breading, you can't go wrong. These things are just gonna taste amazing. I mean, they're already looking good.
It's going, we're fine.
I'm telling you, the best fish fries are when you get that thing up to like steaming hot. When you see steam coming off the oil, that's how you want it. I've done that before, the propane tank. Best fish you'll ever have. Catfish, when you get that oil steaming up hot and you get like almond or peanut oil or something, and you literally can see smoke coming off the oil, and as soon as you touch something in, it's basically flash fried. It's like, and you're done. Here should be the better ones. The only problem with fish fries is that they cool off so fast, these fillets. So you gotta get them within the first, you know.
Gotta get them while they're hot?
Pretty much. They won't taste nearly as good. Dude, well done. They really took, man, they smell good. Ready for the pictures? All right, let's dig in. Take your seat, Dave. They're already starting to get cold.
I got it.
Oh, I was gonna pass you so you could get it off.
I just want to bite at one. I don't want
to hold
it.
No, take some, dude.
Nah, I don't.
I can't eat all that.
You're about to.
I was expecting Mike to.
We'll keep it.
It won't be nearly as good.
I just want
to
try this.
Here, give me a good one. It's good, man. Eat. Eat, man. It won't be nearly as good tomorrow.
No, I'm
good. Oh, yeah, dude. Dude.
Pretty good.
Wow. Wow.
That seasoning is really good.
Mm-hmm. I'm not even a fish guy. And the guy who showed me this, I couldn't resist. Wow.
All right, I'm going to crank up the temperature in here, turn on the fan so we start warming up the other room.
Well. Ooh, still a little hot. Well, I hope you like this video. Like, subscribe, whatever, if you want to see more of this. So. See ya.
Dude.
Man, this is tasty.
It's good shit.
It's amazing. Oh my God.